I just fell in love all over again.
Sleds up there, supposedly only limited to 1,000 people on the hill. I imagine everybody will be getting up really early to get there. Should be exciting.
Welcome to the Big Iron Shootout.
They're forecasting snow all throughout the weekend. But all we can do is say a prayer and hopefully God will bless us with some sunshine. This is a great event and there's going to be some really badass sleds there.
Rex, and I'll be your bellboy. Where would you like your bags?
Saturday morning, our worst fear came that it's snowing. It's snowing pretty hard. So my dilemma is get to the parking lot, get a good spot, and go hungry. I run down to Denny's and get some breakfast first and risk not getting in.
Saturday, March 14th. Snow level rising to 800 meters this afternoon.
Look at that dork in a modular helmet. Oh, wait a minute, I got one of them too. Do you have valet parking?
Welcome to Revelstoke, home of the Big Iron Shootout 2009. All the biggest celebrities in the industry are here.
We got the Twisted Turbo,
Canadian Power Machines, Brian Witherspoon. Number one big guy.
All from Impulse Turbo. What's going on?
How much?
I think it looks better stitched up. Hey!
It's 2,000 cc's. It pulls extremely hard.
Yeah. It made 365 at 7,900 RPM. 250 foot-pounds of torque.
You know where I can redeem this, Doc?
See if she can pull some good shoots today.
Hi, I'm Kevin Forsyth from C3 Power Sports. This is our 100% carbon fiber Apex and M chassis. It's got the Nextech carbon suspension in it, about 460 pounds dry.
It's an 07 rev, slightly modified. Got an RX1 in there. Turbo, propane, 174, F10 skid.
RideSled.com.
I'll race them for slips. Just give me a head start to the first chalet.
Hopefully she's a little brighter up top.
You think her clutch is engaged a little high?
999. You're the last one who gets a ticket.
It's a 600 HO on steroids. It's a 797 spiral cycle motor. It's a Holtz rear suspension, Holtz front suspension.
2009 XR1200, MC Express turbo, racer's edge suspension, mountain mod seat, pretty much a stock, running 14 pounds of boost. Nice and light, weighs in at 525.
We built Nitro up for this year with a 174 and M10 and tried a few different things on it just to see how things would be different.
Pumping up the air shock.
We got a 1200 turbo with 800 horsepower. 800 in the US, 320 in Canada.
That's there. Lots of mice running real fast.
Look at that, I already got grease on my shirt, eh?
You should wash your hair more often, dude.
Oh, it takes real diehards to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning to go snowmobiling on a cloudy day.
But we're tuned now, man. We're all tuned. We're twisted, baby.
You don't think I'm crazy or something?
Cameron, I'm Dan. Good to meet you, Cameron.
Tell us what you're riding.
A 900 with NOS.
We're here to go snowmobile and not go surf the internet.
Just a little fine-tuning.
Doc Zoom, he helped launch the Big Iron back in the day when everybody knew I was crazy.
Sounds kind of complicated.
Playing a game called the Big Iron Shootout.
The Monkey Show.
Welcome to the ozone. This is what happens when the sun burns a layer through the Earth's crust. You become ozoned.
And that white stuff, that's milk.
I think Ozone should be getting a refund from his shampoo supplier, because that is some seriously fucked up haircut.
Nate never seen a hill climb quite like this.
He's got a few screws loose, and I'm not talking about his sled.
Looks like Q-Dog won that one on his little SPS Turbo 700 Dragon.
There it takes it again.
Chalk up another one for Q-Dog. Good job, SPS. Attitude Industries, Holt Racing, USI Skis. Yeah, little Polaris is ripping. Good job. This is going to be crazy. Ozone's starting to back about 50 yards. They got to go right through the big hole that everybody else is making. Hope they make it. Well, that made it about one round, and somebody already got hurt, so blew his knee out. So they got to get him off the mountain. Not hurting him anymore. Get him down to the chopper.
Having fun, eh?
When we found him, his toe was pointing the other direction. We're just getting him off the mountain.
Appreciate it, guys.
Hope he'll be all right. I got some duct tape. We can tape him to the skid.
Started to wheelie out and turned around. And actually, when the sled slammed down, my knee compressed. That was it. Hey, I got good friends, good company. How could you hurt?
Be good.
Thanks.
We're gonna move it up front where it belongs so nobody else gets hurt.
Kyle McHugh.
What are you driving?
1200 Ski-Doo Turbo.
Looks like she's working, huh?
She's working.
Working good.
I'm Dave McHugh. Yeah, we built these things and with modern lights. We got together and we got this dude working good. There's the only yellow thing here today.
Name is Ringer. I'm from Red Deer, Alberta. Yeah, it's working well.
Run up, take the top two from each class. We're going to have ourselves a winner. First run, here we go.
Well, boys, this has been an incredible day.
Well, everybody's heading off to the bullpen to go climb some chutes. Hopefully the sun will come back out again and we can see.
Like a ride on the tide, I can catch you in the wave. Are you brave and the ocean drags you under? Just an apple on the tree, the snake in me sees a light after taking a bite.
Yeah.
He'll be coming back for more.
Go faster, go harder, go higher. I see somebody diving all the way. There's people scrambling everywhere. It was cool.
I'm scoping it out, you never know.
Just like third catwalk, all track on the ground, no skis. Keep your speed up. And of course, with a short track, it's easy to keep the skis in the air.
Accept my apologies.
Well, everybody survived the Big Iron Shootout in a blizzard. It's Sunday morning, and I just got a hold of Paul from Impulse Turbo. Sounds like the boys want to go over and put a whooping on Monster. We got a window to about 11 o'clock to get up on the hill, get her done. Hopefully we can get a helicopter up there and do some filming and go try and conquer Monster. We got a huge storm coming in. We're going to sacrifice a little bit and film today while we got some light and have a crummy drive home, all in the name of conquering Monster.
Robbie from Avid Products. What are you doing, buddy?
Well, get pack some snow today. Show everybody what a 174 3-inch can do.
What's it take to get up this?
Horsepower, nuts, and commitment. Oh, it feels awesome when you make it to the top. If you roll back down to the bottom, it's just, you go back down, try it again.
Yeah.
came here to do.
Thanks, buddy. Freaking rock, man.
Thanks, buddy.
That is one awesome sled for a first year out. Awesome job.
Blanked out a couple times, but you just keep the hammer down. Three turns, it's easy.
What are you driving this year?
That's a new Yamaha Nitro, Alpine Turbo Kit, CR Skid, Lakeside Motorcycle Service Port Work. It has lots of power. Only 15 pounds boost. That's all you need for the monster today.
Goodness gracious.
Chris Brandt, CRHRISBUR.
You were stuck a lot today, Chris. What's with that?
Too low of elevation for me.
What's coming out in 010 for the M's?
The 010 M's are awesome. A little more weight reduction this year and about 15 horsepower. They rock. New hood vents this year, using the frog skins on the front that keeps all the snow out of the airbox area. On the inside of the hood, we've gone to a glue-on insulation. We got trick new skis. In the engine, it's basically a whole new top end, pistons, cylinders, heads. Crankshaft is similar but lightened. Independent dyno reports are showing 163 horsepower. The track on the M Series is an 80 Duro compared to a 90 Duro on the HCR. For 2010, our new M Series seat is higher and got a lot more storage in it besides losing some weight. It's very comfortable.
I think that was well put.
Tony Jenkins.
Hey, Brett. What age do they go to the nursing home?
Kevin from Mount Magic, tell us about this hot rod.
Well, Zoom, this is the 2009 Z1 Limited Edition. It accidentally somehow ended up at my shop. And, well, it had two seats, heated seats, short track. We had no use for it, so we went to work playing with it. Put a 162 underneath it, put a Boondocker D&D hijacker box on it. Factory turbo, turn it up to 280 horse, straight pipe it. It's not a bad sled. It's kind of fun to ride.
Hey!
Watch out for the camera guy!
It only goes one way! Up!
Adam Spackman from Smithfield, Utah.
Got an 09 M8 Boondocker Turbo race gas. Runs pretty good. Thanks to Mountain Magic Sports for setting it up. Brett, it's pretty fun.
I'm Travis Dane from Preston, Idaho. An M1000 with a pipe. We put heads on it, ported it. Jaws can and the Boondocker controller. It's been a really good sled. I really enjoyed it. And it's a blast. Better than a bad day at work.
Weston Bate, Preston, Idaho. My hot rod is an 07 through 09. Got a little bit of everything. You got 09 bumper, 09 stickers, 08 rail. I've got heads, ported jugs. Pipe and can, it rips pretty good.
Matt Jensen. I'm riding an 03 RX1 with the Mountain Performance Supercharger on it. 159-inch Ski-Doo track.
The RTR is a ready-to-ride sled. It comes from Boondockers, fully equipped turbo and graphics and exhaust gas temp, the whole works. All you have to do is put 91 octane gas in it and go rip.
Who do they buy one to?
Any Boondocker dealer or directly from Boondocker. Next year I'm going to do a ride clinic. We're going to offer riding instruction for anybody that wants to come out and learn how to ride with us in the mountains. It's going to be structured as a 3 to 4 day instruction. We include lodging and meals, and it's really going to be a lot of fun. Check our website at deviantsled.com. Give us a call at 208-221-4294.
09 M8 153 limited edition. Got a brace gas turbo on it, running nitromethane.
How much horsepower?
650. That's on low boost. It's insane if you turn the boost up.
Who do they call to get one of these 650 horsepower turbos?
Mountain Magic Sports.
You got some land for sale too?
I do. It's oceanfront property in Preston, Idaho. I'm not in very good shape. Must be getting too old for this stuff. Nah.
I'm the team doctor. I just got the day off. Thank you to Obama. Thank you very much. Got the stimulus going too, but I won't tell you where it's at.
You're just angry.
Angry about getting stimulated or what?
You've already talked about Obama enough.
Hey Zoom, ask me what I'm riding today.
What are you riding today, Mark?
I got a congenital megacolon with a pilonidal cyst and an ostomy bag.
Today I'm riding a M8 turbo.
Who's turbo kit?
It's running pretty good. I don't know. It's Boondocker's Mountain Magic. Put it together and it runs real good. I like it. Time to get scooting.
They're here.
No worries, okay.
All clear. Those are freaking pajamas and I'm not riding with you today. Winter's almost over.
I've wanted to climb that thing 10 times I've been here and it's been doable and I've walked away from it. I'm thinking that's nasty. I'm gonna go give the snow a test, see if it's icy or if there's traction in it. That was a rush. That's why I do this. And I gotta say, I just fell in love all over again.
That's awesome.
Meow, 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 meow. No, it's not, Steve. Can't you see my front end going like this? You make a rock. That was badass.
High five.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is a really good pole.
Rocks and it's steep and you pull and pull and pull and pull. Yep. And you're thinking, I hope I make this. And then you start to see light and you're like, ah.
I got a 16 wide 174 by 3 inch.
Yeah, I like the 3 inch track. Good traction. That rut is like 6 feet deep in that thing. I like it.
I heard that one.
Yeah! Yeah! What motivates you to ride a snowmobile?
Freedom. Good feeling. When you ride a snowmobile, you don't think about anything else. Kind of gets your mind off the rest of the world. And it's fun getting to the top without coming back down backwards.
You ever get scared?
Probably every time. I'm not gonna lie. It's scary. In the same sense, it's fun also. It's the best feeling in the world. You feel like Superman. Adrenaline's rushing through your veins and your heart's going 100 miles an hour, huh, Shane?
Maybe 110. You know, good friends, people that you trust your life with, that's a huge commitment and dedication. Oh, big ol' bump! And the worms ate into his brain.
This is awesome, buddy.
He wasn't worried about rocks, and he should have been.
Shouldn't you be in a nursing home or something?
He ate it this year.
side. No more dead, more dead than alive. Thought about goodbye last night. What she said, it wasn't all right then. Girl, you know I lost her. Expect from me, she's got a lot to earn. This city, you know, it's getting old.
In the snow. In the snow. Stop. I think that's the nastiest shoot around. Death and alive. Thought about the bar last night. What she said, it wasn't all right. That girl, you know, has got a lot to learn. Expect from me, she's got a lot to learn. It's going up the chute. A little bit nasty today. And didn't quite make it. Got stuck in my rut from the other day and couldn't get out of it. Come down and bailed off, and I don't know what happened. I think I flew like a Superman onto a rock shelf and then dove into the snow. The bed looks like it's salvageable. I gotta go, oh, I gotta
go. I did a flip over and I seen the sled go over my head. That's all I was doing was ducking, hiding from it. I knew if that thing pinned me and ducked, it was slowing down the chute. It was gnarly. Oh, I gotta go.
It's a ponytail sticking out of there. You jackass. Yep.
Welcome to Mountain Mod Mania. Yeah, I'm a fast. Revelstoke, British Columbia.
Why are you shaking, Paul Gibbs?
This thing is retarded. It's fast. It's crazy.
Working good?
Oh, yeah. Chuck at Lakeside did the motor for me.
Testing and tuning here, getting her ready for the show.
Get it, get it, get it!
Why are they calling this today?
A fever for tomorrow.
That's all it is, finish. Big boost. And oh yeah, turn. You gotta turn.
Food that the Amies are going to be eating today.
Fortified Yammy food.
Get it. Hey, Q Dog, where are you at?
This is my wife's ring.
Yeah, I like this trailer. The Triton looks good. The flooring's nice. Lighting on the side. Good looking trailer.
Revelstoke Yama Fest. We have a bluebird day today. Snow conditions are just epic. No hero snow today. This is gonna really test both rider and machine. You better have lots of horsepower. You better have a big track, i.e. Camoplast 174. A lot of balls. You know, it's weird. I can hang out of a helicopter and shoot video, but this just gives me the eebie-jeebie standing on the edge like this up here. Afraid that you're gonna just slide off the frickin' cliff. As you can see, it's steep, and these guys are just literally climbing up through the cracks in the cliff.
That's gonna leave a mark. He's the man. He's so cool. I'm gonna come over and give him a big kiss.
We got the three white jerseys up here now. And three Lakeside motors. How's that for you, buddy? Gold, silver, bronze.
Oh.
there, just rolled him. Oh!
If you end up going high, like our two tracks, just let off when you hit the top or you're gonna launch. Got her. Or just come out wherever you want there, my buddy P-Flapper.
Wherever this little bitch takes me, that's where I'm going.
You just let me know when you're going. I'm just fixing my limiter strap, but I gotta come and watch.
Guys on the snowcross track, climbing the hills for nothing.
The excitement is that my fiance went up the Monster Bowl. Very excited for him. This guy's right here. Frenchie, come over here.
I climbed the monster with my fiance's sled. That's a 800 rev.
03.5 rev right here. It's stock. It's got the extreme track on 150 by 2.5-inch lugs. 3-inch pitch. It really makes a difference. Like, for a stock sled, it really chews good. It's all about judging. You poke the hill a couple of times, and I just had a feeling I could pull it. You don't really realize it till you get to the top. Everything stops until you get to the top. And then, I don't know, just a heck of a rush. Thanks, babe. She's my best fan.
Next year.
So looks good, boys.
We're going to Turtle.
Have some fun out there.
We'll get him out of there because we're riding behind you. So.
Hey, what's going on there, young fella? How come you're not full of piss and vinegar?
Chico or the Rebel Stoker at?
I'm enjoying my $17.89 can of Copenhagen Long Cut.
Thank you.
Boy, that's a nice trailer, Greg.
That is a nice trailer.
Isn't that cool?
You can give Greg a little surprise now. Give him a little buddy bar.
Can you show us the birth of an environmentalist?
It's got no drive.
You gotta tighten the bolt next time you got it off.
Who brings you so horny, yeah?
Got no drive.
That is incredible.
Got no drive.
Very nice.
no drive.
Doing a mountain mod ride for American Snowmobiler magazine. Right now we got Jerry Matthews, Starting Line Products. Got the James guys from Enterprise, Oregon, the outdoor toy store, which is Aaron Krebs.
Little pump gas in the turbo for a ride today. New concept, buddy.
Hey, what's cracking?
A naturally aspirated against the turbo, they don't stack.
I understand what you're saying because you're building sea level boost or power at 8,000 feet.
Exactly.
And that's the difference. Beacons, probes, and shovels, everybody got them?
Who in their right mind would wear something as geeky as that?
Darth Vader would. Luke, I'm not your father.
I can't believe you're wearing one of those helmets.
This is Jerry Matthews, Starting Line Products, here on this beautiful snowy day. Brought up a couple sleds, Polaris 800. We've got Powder Pro skis on the nose of it. It's got our single pipe on it, a set of V-Force reeds, and it's got a new Dino Jet Power Commander on it. This is one of the performance packages we're going to be offering for next year. Skidoo 800. Again, it's got Powder Pro skis on the nose of it. Our single pipe on this sled, set of our heads, high flow intake kit, hot air illumination kits, the venting kits on the chassis. We've also put a team drive shaft conversion to utilize the team secondary clutch on it. Combination works extremely well, performs great. Starting Line Products, phone number there is 208-529-0244, www.startinglineproducts.com. Imagine that.
Other way, look back the other way. Beautiful!
As Dustin with Outlaw Motorsports up in Enterprise, Oregon, this is the hot rod for this year. It's a Yamaha Nitro XTX platform, long tracked, 162 easy ride suspension, 162 Camoplast 2.5 extreme track. Impulse race turbo system, the biggest, baddest, gnarliest SOB there is. 2871 hybrid turbo, external wastegate, all the bells and whistles to make 400 horsepower.
This is Cody with Outlaw Motorsport, and this is my bad boy for this year. We have a Nitro RTX chassis with a 162 easy ride, Camoplast 2.5 track, stage 3 MPI supercharger in this bad boy, and it's hooked up with the motor work and the valve springs, and it just plain rips. Instant throttle response. And of course, we got the best mod of all again this year is the nice chickie on the tank. So, you know, that adds 10 miles an hour right there. We also had the nice Skins protective gear seat cover on this bad boy.
Where were you yesterday?
Go to school.
What's going on?
We're gonna go out for another good ride.
Day two. Oh, by the way, Doc, it's good to have you back. We are going to ride and we're gonna jump and we're gonna do drops and we're gonna do carbs, brodies, donuts, cookies, whatever you wanna call it. The overall goal is to have fun, to shoot some good pictures, and to ride some of the nastiest mountain iron that money can buy, from mild to wild. Anything that you want, we got it here. We're talking blowers, we're talking turbochargers, we're talking pump gas turbos, big bore kits, pipes, the whole deal. What's unique about these sleds, they aren't just point and shoot big mountain killers. They're in the trees, and that's where you want them. Steep slopes, lots of trees, lots of powder, and going up through the nasty chutes and draws where the trees are just as wide as your ski stands. That's what it's all about, Doc. That's mountain riding.
We'll have fun.
What do you think of them, Zoomer?
Hey, here's another modular helmet. Hey, it's Doc Zoom.
Hey, Caitlin, what's happening? It's Tony Jenkins from Idle Falls, Idaho. Just love the sport. Just go out and have fun. Woo!
You're just a little kid. You shouldn't be doing stuff like that.
I know.
You barely reached puberty.
Hi, I'm Aaron from the Outdoor Toy Store in Hood River, Oregon. I'm an Arctic Cat player stealer. I was invited over here for the second year in a row. Decided to come over and have a good time like always. First, I was gonna talk about our 09 Polaris Assault. It's an 800. Starting at the skis, we did SLP Powder Pros, right into Zebro's A-arms, shocks, and then comes through the motor with all SLP motor work. It has our clutching, SLP intake, our custom Trail Tech bars. As a whole, I think it's one of the funnest sleds I've ridden. It's made to be beat on and still be reliable.
Now, why would you wear a tech vest?
It's the only way to keep you safe. It just gives you a peace of mind. No matter if you're just going down the trail or playing, you always just throw it on. It's safety. And same with my knee guards and my HMK boots.
Brent was here. Sorry about that one.
I don't know how people don't have fun snowmobiling.
I'm Jared Sessions with Boondocker Performance. Up here with Am Snow. We've got some pump gas turbo kit. Yeah, I did say pump gas and turbo in the same sentence. Got an M8 RTR. RTR stands for ready to ride, pull the rope, put gas in it, pump gas and oil, and you're ready to rock. Then I've got this Dragon Assault over here. 6 to 8 pounds of boost, depending on your elevation. Building somewhere between 165 to 200 real horsepower. Boondocker started off kind of in the nitrous business, kind of evolved into a control block for all the EFI sleds so they can get fuel control with their high performance modifications, and we've evolved into 4-stroke turbos and now into the 2-stroke turbo market, and we've really got a solid, reliable, really consumer drivable product. You know, these pump gas sleds are a sled for everyone. Awesome throttle response, drive it just like a stalker, and no weird spots in them at all, they just flat run. 208-542-4411, or you can get to our website at www.boondockers.com.
Oh, just taking a little rest. I'll be good in a few.
What happened back there?
A little flat. I feel like a sissy laying here on the ground.
Now, what am I going to tell Rocky tomorrow?
As long as I can, like, not have to stand up.
How's your stiff back? We're gonna wrap up Mod Mod 7, over 30 chutes to be pulled. Crazy Canadian there, gonna team up. We've got Q-Dog, J-Dog, Tony Dog, Whacker Dog, and I'm Doc Zoom Dog.
I don't know if we're gonna be able to narrate, man. We're so puckered up, man. We just do what we do. But if you hooked it up to the brainwaves, you'd see a whole other story.
Why super clamps?
Because they keep my sled from falling off the truck when I'm going 50 miles an hour down the logging road. They're simple and they work. They're good stuff, real good stuff. Love the super clamps.
Looks like you need some rear super clamps.
Rear super clamps? What are you looking at my bum for?
They make rare ones, dude.
Rear?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Kevin from C3 Power Sports. These are carbon fiber chassis here, complete sleds. Lightweight, strong, take a beating, go to the top. Right now we're doing the M chassis. We're just starting on the XP chassis. Been putting Apex motors in them. Lightweight, lots of power, good running, smooth.
So what all is carbon fiber on this?
Pretty much everything. Whole chassis, bulkhead is all one piece carbon fiber. Carbon fiber hood, side panels, carbon fiber rails in the skid. Yeah, this sled's got about 85 pounds off of stock.
Talking about maybe doing a Mount Mod 8 project sled. Tell us about that.
Well, we're in. I think we should do an XP chassis with a 1200 turbo in there. You can call us at 250-833-3538 or on the web, c3powersports.com. And we're up in Salmon Arm, British Columbia.
What do we call this? This is the Mount Mod Invitational number 7. We got hooked up with Dan Davidoff. You know who he is? The crazy Canadian.
We are in the Valley of the Chutes.
So you go beyond,
yeah,
and then just carve it in on that little bowl where the snow boulders are, and then straight up. Oh, it's tough. It's tough. The first 100 feet is the hardest part of this chute, I guarantee it.
There's two more right in this bowl, and then we'd put the chopper down again and we'd move over to the next bowl.
I'm gonna go to the bottom, check them out. Looks like good chutes.
It's May 2nd. We're up in BC. We'll do some chutes today.
SPS Racing was catching up to that little kitty cat.
Well, you were about to motor him over, weren't you?
Yeah.
More than one tree.
Not good.
Bowl 3 and shoot day with the Crazy Canadian, just outside of Nelson, British Columbia.
Nice job.
That was fun.
That was pretty cool. I'm like speechless. I don't even know what to say about it.
What time is it, Lyle?
Showtime.
Showtime. Myself and Shane Stanger. She's about 1,200 vertical feet of pure nasty, nasty chute. But it's twisted. It's all twisted around here. The Valley of the Chutes, West Kootenays, British Columbia. Pure terror.
It was so icy in that nasty chute. I probably shouted out 5 times, please God, please God, please God, because I didn't think I was going to make it. It was just spinning out, man. I thought I was done. And there was no snow to dig it in there. It was just, it was icy. It was so, so scary. And the rush at the top, man, I wet my pants, I'm pretty sure.
What were you thinking when you got to the top?
What a rush, you know? Thank you, God. I got her done. Got her done! It was fun. Nice it job. Was fun, man.
So tell us a little bit about your sled. I mean, you had to have some pretty good equipment to get up there. Tell us about your sled.
Well, unfortunately, I broke the crazy sled in my second climb when I clipped that rock. So I pulled that chute on the main jet sled. We got a 174 inch track from Rec Supply. We've got the Ice Age rails. We got the twisted turbo on it. Brian Witherspoon with Canadian Power Machines built it. It's got the mountain mod seat, you know, and the sled has just been amazing all season long. No issues other than that rock I smoked today. That was the first issue all year long. So we'll get that fixed up and we'll try again next weekend.
Who's this twisted turbo guy?
Shane Stanger. He's out of Utah there. He is just a brilliant man, and he's got a great product, and these twisted turbos work. They work. We've seen today alone probably 5 or 6 separate twisted turbo sleds just rip these hills up. And during the season, I've seen another 5. So, you know, everybody's having real good luck with the twisted turbos. You climb that nasty chute with me, the bugger. That's all right. It's a twisted chute.
Stop throwing
Okay, we got Q Dog and Tony Jenkins. They're climbing this nasty little chute up in the valley of the chute. There he is. Here comes Q Dog in the picture. Oh, we got trouble. Oh no. Oh dear. Oh no. Oh dear. I think it stopped.
No!
If they spun out on the ice from what Renee just did and what I just experienced, the chutes are nasty icy.
Yeah, baby!
What they're doing is they're picking up Dan and Shane's sled. It was a one-way street up there. So now they're having to airlift them off the top. Put them to another spot that's accessible. You guys rock, both of you. That was just a phenomenal climb. Is taking it to a new level. How old are you, big guy?
15 years old now.
Yeah, 15. And there are seasoned veterans that are 25 that will not do stuff you're doing, big guy. Way to step it up, man.
And the Gentry over here, he stepped it up. Almost made it to the top.
Way to step it up. That's how you start them, one day at a time. One shoot at a time. Eventually, you're kicking butt, crazy Canadian style. And I'll be an old fart by then, and you can take over my spot, okay?
All right. I have an Arctic Cat HTR with the HPS silencer.
You climbed your first big chute today, and what happened, dude?
I was going a little bit too slow, and I hit some ice boulders, hit a little tree, sucked me off into the cliff, and got stuck.
Instead of helping, we just throw snowballs at them.
I see you're wearing a tech vest. Why is that?
Because I don't feel like having any broken ribs anytime soon.
You rode good today, son. Well, when the weather's like not too good in Cook City, and this is what we do, we go play in the trees. The thing is, we're up here, we're having fun. You're always meeting new friends, and you really find out what a good bunch of guys snowmobilers are. And that's what it's all about. Staying off all the hills that are dangerous, a good slide, because this is extreme danger for avalanche up here today. Until this snow settles and locks in, it's really, really dangerous up here. So you really need to stay in the tree, stay down below, look at the mountains, and if it looks dangerous, don't do it. Just go play in the trees. There's plenty of boondocking to be had. Stay alive. Back at you. What could you do for me? What could you do for me?